Hello everyone, this is Professor Srinivasan here, back once again with another concept in financial management. Before I get into the discussion on the concept which I'm going to discuss today, first of all, let me apologize to you profusely for the long gap since my earlier upload. Well, I've been busy in certain other commitments, and that is possibly one of the reasons why I could not upload content since the last possibly a couple of months. Well, anyway, having gotten that to the side, let's begin with this particular video. Now, what is it that I'm going to discuss? Well, during the last couple of months, a lot of you have messaged me to explain the concept of cheapest to deliver bonds. Now, what exactly do we mean by cheapest to deliver bonds, and where is it relevant? Well, first, let us discuss the relevance part. The concept of cheapest to deliver bonds is particularly relevant in the case of interest rate futures. Now, for those of you who have attended my interest rate futures lectures, you would know that interest rate futures involves the buying and selling of some notional bonds. That is, the buyer of the interest rate futures is notionally buying some bonds, and the seller of the interest rate futures is notionally selling some bonds. The problem arises when these interest rate futures are proposed to be settled by delivery. Because if it is going to be settled by delivery, then the seller obviously has to deliver some bonds. But the problem is, which bond does it deliver? Because when the contract was entered into, it was a notional buying and selling of bonds. To resolve this problem, the seller is provided with a list of approved securities from which he can choose any one for the purpose of delivering and settling the transaction. Now the question is, which is the bond that the seller will select? Obviously, the seller is going to select the bond which is cheapest for him to deliver. So that is where the term cheapest to deliver comes from. Now, the important question that arises in your mind is, sir, how do we calculate which is the cheapest bond to deliver? Let's understand this with the help of an example. So let's have a look at this example. In March 2020, XYZ Bank sold some 7% interest rate futures underlying notional 7.5% coupon bonds. The exchange provides following details of eligible securities that can be delivered. So this effectively represents the basket of securities. That is the list of securities which is provided to the seller from which he can select any one which is the cheapest to deliver and settle the transaction. So they have given 7.96 GOI 2023. This is the quoted price of the bond, and then they have given something called as the conversion factor. Now, what exactly is the conversion factor? See, these bonds which are in the basket are not of similar type, in the sense that if you look at the first bond, it has got a coupon of 7.96 and is maturing in 2023, whereas the second bond has got a coupon of only 6.55 and it's got a longer maturity duration as well, 2025. So these bonds have been given a conversion factor, or what you can refer to as weights. Now, what is the use of giving this conversion factor? See, this conversion factor tells us as to what should be the amount that the buyer of the interest rate futures should pay to the seller of the interest rate future, or in other words, the seller of the securities. Recommend the security that should be delivered by XYZ if the future settlement price is 1000, and if the seller decides to deliver this security, then the amount that he will receive as sale consideration will be 1000 into the conversion factor 1.0370. So the conversion factor gives the weightage for determining the price which is receivable by the seller from the buyer. So now let's calculate which amongst these is the cheapest to deliver bond for the seller. Now, let's have security. This is 7.96 2023. The settlement price. Is 1000, and of course this is going to remain the same for all the securities. The conversion factor for this particular security is given as 1.0370, which means the sale consideration received by seller will be 1000 into 1.0370, that is 1037. Now this is the amount that the seller will receive when he delivers the security. But have you ever thought, where is the seller going to get the security from? Obviously he is going to buy it from the market. And at what price will he buy it from the market? He is going to buy it from the market at the quoted price, that is this price. So you can say this is the purchase cost, or you can refer to this as the inflow to the seller, and this is the outflow to the seller. So the purchase cost is 1037.4. Therefore, the gain or the loss, in this case there will be a loss because he's going to buy the security as 1037.40 and deliver the securities to the buyer of the interest rate futures and get a sum of 1037. So there's going to be a loss of 0.40. Let's take the next security, 6.55 2025. The settlement price is 1000, but there's a conversion factor of 0.9060, which means the seller upon delivery of the securities to the buyer will receive 906, but he will purchase the security at 926.40. This will give him a loss of 20.4. Let's take the third security, that is 6.80 2029. The settlement price is 1000. The conversion factor is 0.9195, which means the inflow to the seller upon delivery of this security will be 919.5, and the outflow to the seller will be 877.5. So in this case you will notice he's making a profit. Fourth security, 6.85 2026. It's got a settlement price of 1000 and it's got a conversion factor of 0.9643. That means the inflow to the seller will be 964.30 and the outflow would be 972.30. Now in this case there is going to be a loss. The fifth security, 8.44 2027. The settlement price obviously will be 1000. Now this has got a conversion factor of 1.1734, which means the inflow to the seller will be 1173.4 and the outflow will be 1146.30. Now in this case the profit, and finally we have 8.85 2028. This has got a settlement price of 1000 and it's got a conversion factor of 1.2428, which means the inflow to the seller would be 1242.80, and the purchase price, that is the outflow, would be 1201.70. So in this case, again, the profit. Now think about it logically. If you were the seller and you had the option to deliver any one of these securities, which would you choose to deliver? You would obviously choose to deliver that particular security where the loss is the minimum, or in other words, profit is the maximum. So that means you will obviously select this particular stock. Where the profit is the maximum. So this is the concept of cheapest to deliver bond in case of interest rate futures. So I hope, students, you found this particular short video quite useful. And just as a side bit of information, this particular question has been given by the Institute of Chartered Accountants in its mock test paper. And this, as far as the institute is concerned, is a pretty new type of question, because this is not a question that you would normally find in the practice manual or the study module. So once again, I hope you found this video useful. If you did find it useful, please do share the video so that the maximum number of students can benefit out of this. That's all for now. Take care. Stay healthy and ciao.